Welcome to the SNAP Miss World 2012 Grand Finale held at Jamhuri Park, and it's all go on the red carpet as the guests arrive for tonight's glamorous event.
I'm Rushma, we're the designers. We're also going to be dressing up Miss World.
And here, arriving now, is the Miss World entourage. And Miss Caribbean. And Miss Europe. With the reigning Miss World.
Welcome to Nairobi.
And they are being welcomed to the gala night by Mr. Sheni Adetu, the group managing director and CEO of East Africa Breweries. Tonight is the final night, and we will know who gets the crown and is going to represent us in China as the SNAP Miss World Kenya 2012 with the cash prize of 1 million Kenya shillings. Kindly stand for the national anthem. Very, very warm welcome to you to the grand finale of Miss World Kenya 2012. My name is Joey Muthengi.
My name is Gaetano Kagwa. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing to you Miss World England. Alize Mounter from England. Gentlemen, a round of applause. Now, ladies and gentlemen, also in the house, we have Miss World Caribbean, Amanda Villanova from Puerto Rico. The reigning Miss World 2011, Ivian Sarcos from Venezuela.
Big round of applause.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, not only in Kenya, but in the world, to have three Miss Worlds here in Kenya, Miss Europe, Miss Caribbean, and the reigning Miss World 2011, Ivian Sarcos, Venezuela. Please give them a round of applause.
Very, very nice. I'd say that's more of a big surprise than a small surprise, but as you all know, this is what we've been waiting for.
Let's have a very quick word from our group managing director and CEO, Mr. Sheni Adetu.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to Miss World Kenya 2012. I'm so delighted to be here with you on this fantastic occasion. At East African Breweries Limited, we are intent at being the most celebrated, the most admired business in every part of East Africa. And that for us means being an employer of choice, delivering superior shareholder returns, and being a force for good in the society. We are immensely proud to be associated with this high-profile, unique event. And the reason is that between SNAP and Miss Kenya, we see a strong commonality. The commonality coming from the fact that SNAP represents today's modern woman, sophisticated, economically and socially empowered, wanting to look good and feel good, and actually staying balanced between domestic and professional lives. And that's why we call the SNAP personality the SNAP sister. We are hoping that by the sponsorship of Miss Kenya 2012, we'll be offering you, our consumers, great times and great experiences. So enjoy the show. Let's get on with it. I can't wait to see the winner. Thank you.
Now, I did mention a boot camp, of course. There was the Snap Beauty boot camp I mentioned earlier on, and they put in a lot of hard work to make sure that the ladies would be fit and ready for tonight's event.
Yeah, so if you're wondering what have we been up to for the past couple of weeks, what have our ladies been doing with themselves, we're about to find out right now.
After the national auditions of over 500 potential hopefuls all over Kenya,
the initials GK on a government car, what does that stand for?
I don't know. I don't know what they mean.
You know, both married.
It all started with the callbacks. And they are all excited.
I'm happy.
Seriously?
Yes, you are. Really? You
seriously?
Yes.
I'm all ready for the academy, and guess what? Huh? My bags are already packed.
Seriously?
Yes. And I'ma see you all at the academy.
Seriously,
I'm
not joking. Come on.
You're lying.
Yes. Just been selected.
And getting all the support that they needed.
You went again to try. Why? I thought you were done last year.
No, I just to give it a try again.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then contents.
Thank you.
Are you sure?
Thank you.
The lucky few start off at the Nairobi Snap Beauty Boot Camp.
I actually think this is still a dream. I need somebody to wake me up because it's going so fast and I'm so excited.
And for the next 28 days, the training schedule is gonna be tough, with daily morning exercises in the gym, pool, or beach. It's definitely their time to get fit. And let's meet their trainers and experts.
It can make a huge difference even by tonight if they can just focus on me and take some tips from me.
You have to look at the eye level of the camera, make sure that there's enough of a shift between the camera and between the judges. I'm an image consultant, so I'm kind of helping them groom them to become proper ladies.
If you put Vaseline on your teeth, it prevents dry mouth.
So how much Vaseline should I put?
I think they're as ready as they can get right now.
The ladies went down to the Snap Beauty Boot Camp at Hill Park Tiwi Beach on the South Coast.
Bye Nairobi, Mombasa, here we come.
And now they arrive at their Snap Beauty Boot Camp at Hill Park Tiwi Beach. And immediately they carry on with their training.
Today's lesson on your catwalk is about confidence in your bikini.
Tony goes tough on the ladies and doesn't stop.
But I'm having pleasure punishing the girls. You know, the more the mistakes they make, the more they stand in the sun. And I think that's a good punishment.
I believe that you gain more confidence when you're walking in front of people. You get used to it. And that's when you, I can say, you get immune to the eyes of people.
And one of my favorite bits is Derek's training session when he was slightly disappointed.
We're going to have to do a little bit of a punishment. Can you please drop down and you're going to give me some push-ups right now.
1, 2, 3, 4.
This is for all the yes. 2. This is for all the yups. 3. This is for all the coulds. 4. It is could, would, should. This is for all the 6. 7. Can't think of anything else. The time for Mr. Nice Guy is over. This is where the rubber meets the road.
We know he means well, and it's all to help the girls.
Every beauty queen must have a cause or a CSR project that they're passionate about. And I'm going to help them put together the thoughts on their projects or their CSR causes in a logical yet manner that flows and is coherent.
They had a chance to visit places.
Something that the models can have, the contestants can have as a meal.
Learn
how it was started and how Portuguese took over.
It's so nice, history, I really like history, so just being here, I've been here before, but then you know I wasn't that interested, but now I'm a lot more interested to learn and to know what it is about and everything, yeah.
And still train. These pics are amazing.
The ladies left boot camp and headed for their CSR project at Shimba Hills National Park in association with the Kenya Wildlife Service.
All know that water is life.
And there you have it, beauty with a purpose. And more activities.
Sorry, have you tested it?
Yes, I have.
I don't like the smell on my finger.
Hands away from the table, ladies, and away from the dishes.
What kind of fish is this?
It's kingfish.
Key to good fish is moist.
Now, let's take you back to find out why they were actually cooking. And welcome to Derek's session on fine dining.
This lady's goes in the mouth like this. Not a like this. These are called tines. So the tines are faced down and then you put your fingers on top.
And after 28 days, all this hard work has paid off, don't you think?
It's a very exciting night here at Miss World Kenya 2012. The poor judges, though, have that impossible decision of choosing one out of all these lovely ladies.
It must be very interesting because I know you've been following them around. How has that been for you, Joey? I was unable to join you because I was walking in my high heels practicing. But how was that?
It was emotional. It was a lot of tissue was involved. Every week I found myself getting attached to these ladies on eviction night. A lot of tears. The first eviction was especially hard. We had four ladies leave the Snap Beauty Boot Camp. That was Daisy, Florence, Evelyn Jockey, and Lucy all had to go. So check out how that went down.
Lucy and Evelyn, thank you for being here.
Daisy, I'm sorry you're going home.
Florence, that means you are going home. Thank you for coming this far. Yvonne, you are being evicted. Nikita, you are hereby evicted from Miss World Kenya 2012.
I had a wonderful time in the academy and I learned a lot. Thank you once again.
I'm disappointed, but I'm grateful for the opportunity, so better luck next time.
Ivy, you have been evicted from the Miss World Kenya 2012.
Okay, may the best girl win and enjoy the rest of your stay in the academy.
Dana, you've got a beautiful smile, but that's not enough. And on that note, I'm sorry, but Susan, you're out.
It's not a thing that I will change, 'cause you're amazing, just the way you are.
I would have sung much better, but I'm feeling so low right now. But I'm happy.
She was my roommate. She was very cooperative. Susan is a very amazing person. She has a fantastic personality. She has a big heart. I was expecting to go home personally, and I almost broke down when...
Actually glad that I made it this far.
It has been a great experience. So many people who wanted to be in my position, but they were not.
Susan, can you imagine singing after being evicted? Would you be able to?
I can't even sing to start with, but what Susan did was absolutely admirable. And because we love her so much, because she has a place in our hearts, that is why we have invited her back this evening to perform for you. So please, put your hands together for none other than...
Susan!
Why is it? Why is it? I wanna know,
And I'm just happy I'm not the judge of the difficult, near impossible task of picking one beauty queen. So how about we meet our judging panel and get to know who's on that end of the room?
Now, starting off with our very far left, we have Rachel Mutindi. We also have Nelly Mshimba, Dr. Amrit Kalsi, former Miss India, Kenya, Miss Terry Mungai, franchise holder of Miss World Kenya, CEO of Ashley's. Christian Jorolamak, thank you very much. Very cool, I like the way you're dressed. Nice and casual. Francis Gugwa next to Nelly, thank you very much. Bogwa. Sally Carago is next to Francis. It is now time for us to take our very first look at our ladies and their outfits presented and dressed by African Heritage for the very first time. These are your top 10. Shamim Fawaz, 18, hardworking, honest, I like that, assertive and intelligent. Shamim number 8, one more time on the catwalk, giving us the walk. I love the way they walk, very inspiring.
Number 10 there is Sadia Abdiwahab, 20 years of age, passionate, genuine, and she's a go-getter.
Remember, they are dressed by African Heritage, and they are looking truly inspirational in the African attire. Pauline Akwacha. On the ramp, only 24 years of age, full of energy, result-orientated, extremely intelligent, believes in what she says and brings sparkle to people's life. Indeed, bring a sparkle this evening.
Miss Caroline Kirigo, 20 years of age, very dedicated, social, and a spiritual girl.
You have to love the colors. It's a mixture of red, yellow, black, and of course the traditional necklace.
Miss Emma Zanel, age 20, hardworking, intelligent, goal-oriented, and she never gives up.
None of these ladies have given up to make it this far. Fiona Atieno, age 20, kind, humble, hardworking, and she has a passion to give back to the society.
Here is Faith Wanyama, 20 years of age, a God-fearing young lady. She's humble and self-starting as well.
Yes, a round of applause is needed, please. It takes a lot of courage to walk on the ramp. It's not an easy thing. Rachel Wakanyi, only 18 years of age, driven and social, loves meeting new people, experiencing new things, and she has a passion for this lovely country, Kenya, and would love to inspire the youth. Give it up for Rachel!
And the ever-lovely Evelyn Maina, age 23. She's a cheerful, courageous, inquisitive young lady, and very reliable also.
Please put your hands together for Evelyn! Diana Mora, stepping onto the catwalk, age 22. Intelligent young lady who loves to learn new things and reading. Absolutely generous and down to earth, and to top it off, very modest indeed. Please put your hands together for Diana Mora. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, your top 10 for the Miss World Kenya 2012. One last round of applause. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to get a very quick word from our franchise holder, Miss Terry Mungai.
Miss World Kenya has been a journey, and this is our 9th year. Miss World is about, not just about beauty, it is beauty with a purpose. And for us in Kenya, I have taken that beauty with a purpose literally to uplift the livelihood of our young women. I'm happy to say in the 9 years, we have created jobs. We have changed lives of young people. For example, the young women that you're going to be seeing here tonight started a journey over 5 weeks ago. They have been taught how to walk, be confident, be able to speak, and not only for the pageant, because these are not things that you can take away from them. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been possible and it's bigger than it has ever been. This is thanks to EABL through their new brand, Snap. I'd also like to thank the parents of all the girls who came out for auditions, because it's evidence of believing and faith in Miss World Kenya.
We do have some musical entertainment throughout the evening. Coming up first on the stage, our very own homegrown lady. She goes by the name of Amelina, and the first song she'll be performing is called Shine.
Amelina, ladies and gentlemen.
Amelina, it's all yours.
Moyoni nilijua ntafika pale ntapewa mabawa kupita ukingoni. I had a dream so strong inside of me. I just knew one day I'd set it free. Na hatimaye wakati wangu umefika, hatimaye subira yangu imelipa, wakati wako umefika. Oh, shine, shine, said it's your time. Wakati wako umefika. Oh, shine, 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 shine. Now don't you stress about the who's, the what's, the when's, the why's. If you've got a song in you, sing it out and let it shine. La da 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 da, la da 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 da, da da di dum. TRBD, siku yako itakamu si, usi babaike, usi, usi huzunike, sabu hatimaye. Wakati wako utafika, hatimaye subira yako italipwa. Wakati wako umefika. Oh, shine, shine, said it's your time. Wakati wako
como é ficar. Oh, shine. It's your time and it's my time and it's our time. Said it's your time and it's my time and it's our time. Yeah, it's your time and it's our time and it's God's time. So baby,
good luck.
Let's get back to the action. Ladies and gentlemen, of course you know that it takes sophistication, it takes class, and it takes beauty indeed to be in this competition. And with direct support of EABL, let's hear it from Carol Ndungu. She's the marketing director Kenya for EABL.
Hi, as you may be aware, the fastest growing economy in the world is not India or Brazil or China, it's actually women. We at EABL have chosen to get after this economy, to get after this consumer group with a brand called Snap. Snap is a fruit flavored alcoholic beverage that's designed for women. It is designed specifically for the modern woman who seeks to embrace modernity, who is confident, stylish, bold, and who wants to express themselves as a woman. So tonight, we are confident that we can crown a Miss Kenya that will represent us in the Miss World stage and that can go on to win the crown of Miss World. We are empowering that woman as she is crowned tonight with 1 million Kenya shillings to set her up straight. So she will be going as a millionaire to the world stage in Macau, China, and then can come back here and do the good things that we are all expecting for her to do. So enjoy the night, and it all starts with a snap.
All right, well, the ladies are backstage eagerly awaiting to come back to the runway and show you what they've got with their second look this evening. Please welcome our final 10 contestants.
Thank you.